so soon after my previous comic video. Another inconsistency in William Lane Craig's philosophy. William Lane Craig often says in debates that his opponent should prove that atheism is correct, disregarding the fact that atheism doesn't have to prove anything, atheism doesn't have any positive claims. The atheist doesn't have anything like God in his life until a theist comes along and says, there is a God. But William Lane Craig knows that, and he says it in an absent-minded moment.
On the atheist view, there is no such being or person as God.
When the atheist tells him, what do you want me to prove? William Lane Craig says, prove that God does not exist. When he's told that you can't prove that God does not exist, you can't prove a universal negative, William Lane Craig says, yes, you can. You can prove that there are no Muslims in the American Senate. You can prove that there are no living Tyrannosaurus Rex on Earth.
I disagreed with what you said there.
It is impossible to
impossible to prove something does not exist. That's silly. Of course you can prove something does not exist. We can prove, for example, that there are no living Tyrannosaurus Rex on the face of the earth. We can prove that there are no Muslims of the United States Senate.
But he is making a grave mistake of making an analogy between a transcendent thing that he describes God to be and a physical thing, like a human being, a Muslim, a dinosaur. My objection here is that, no, it is not a good analogy, it's not a proper analogy, it's no analogy at all to say that you can prove that God does not exist in the same way as you can prove that there are no Muslims in the Senate and there are no Tyrannosaurus Rex dinosaurs on Earth. Lately, in Denmark, he had a debate with Professor Kappel in the question session. One Christian asks Professor Kappel, having in mind the definition for God, what will be your method of showing that God does not exist? Professor Kappel answered, well, a century ago, scientists thought, assumed that there exists a substance, a phlogiston, which enables the fire to burn. But after that, after discovering the things that oxygen and other substances do when there is a fire, they discovered, the scientists, that there is no need for phlogiston, so they discarded this notion. And that is why they said that no, there exists no phlogiston.
From this pure definition, forget the other thousands of gods, and even the Christian God, just take God as you've defined it, that you need to actually show that this isn't even a possibility. Can you show that? Or can you at least provide some positive reasons why such a being cannot, or entity cannot exist? All I've heard is just doubts, so I want to hear some positive reasons.
Reasons that such a being doesn't exist. Well, the reasons of the same kind as our reasons to think that the phlogiston doesn't exist. Phlogiston, you don't know what it is. Well, before modern chemistry was invented, people thought that you should explain fire and certain chemical reactions by postulating a certain entity. But then, at a later stage, it turned out that you can explain these events in other ways.
And immediately after that, William Lane Craig had an objection. And he voiced my objection.
Well, I think it's a mistake for Dr. Kappel to keep comparing God to existent physical or non-existent physical entities like phlogiston or Tor. In these cases where you're talking about physical entities, if they existed, you would see them, or you would have empirical evidence of them. And so the fact that you've demonstrated that phlogiston doesn't exist, or that Tor doesn't exist, doesn't have any bearing upon a question like whether or not God, as classically conceived, as a transcendent creator and designer of the universe, exists.
The inference to the Beck's explanation goes as follows. Suppose you have competing explanations. One is that God exists, one is doesn't entail that God exists. And you think the one that does not entail that God exists is the best, then that's your reason for thinking that God doesn't exist.
We can prove that there are no Muslims of the United States Senate. We can prove, for example, that there are no living Tyrannosaurus rex on the face of the earth. That's silly.